We are now going to turn our attention to energy. There's no more important topic that we will discuss through the rest of the semester than energy. Everything we do requires energy. And the biggest challenge that we're facing as a planet is how we're going to obtain the energy we need to do our personal activities and, even more importantly, global activities, manufacturing, transportation, communication, heating and cooling. All of these things require energy. And as we learned when we discussed types of chemical reactions, burning of fossil fuels, combustion reactions of carbon-based fossil fuels always produce CO2. And we now recognize that we are putting too much CO2 in the atmosphere as a result of the combustion reactions we're doing globally. We need to come up with some other way to obtain our energy needs. And the good news is that we as a community, as a global community, are working on that. But let's turn our attention to getting a better understanding of exactly what energy is. So I'm going to give you a definition from the textbook. By the way, this information is found in Chapter 3 of the Chem 2A textbook, and we're specifically looking at sections 3.4 and 3.5. So, a definition of energy: the ability to do work or transfer heat, which itself is a form of energy. So let's just look at this underlined portion, the ability to do work. Notice that it doesn't really say what energy is. It's describing what it does, which indicates that once you get to the fundamental level of things, trying to define terms like matter and energy, it's difficult because you really can't take them apart into any smaller topics. You can't deconstruct them anymore. They form the basis of our reality. So we're going to have to content ourselves with a description of what energy is. It's the ability to do work. There are two major types of energy. Kinetic energy, abbreviated K period E period, and potential energy, abbreviated P period E period. Two major types of energy. Energy will be expressed in one of these forms or the other. Let's take a look at the form that you're probably more familiar with in terms of being able to grasp as a concept. Kinetic energy, which is the energy an object possesses due to its motion. Notice that we can quantitate that relationship. Kinetic energy equals 1/2 mass times velocity squared. Now, I'm not going to require you to memorize this equation or to use it in a calculation, but something very important to note: V stands for velocity, and notice that term is squared. So what that means is that small changes in the speed or the velocity that an object possesses will exponentially increase the kinetic energy that that object possesses. An example of kinetic energy is a ball rolling or a baseball being pitched. Anytime you see an object in motion, the object possesses kinetic energy because it's moving. Notice that heat itself is related to the thermal motion that molecules have. The hotter something is, the more heat it contains, the more rapidly, the faster its molecules are moving, which means that it has greater kinetic energy. The other type of energy is potential energy. And notice this is considered to be stored energy, or energy that an object possesses due to its position. Chemical energy is a type of potential energy. By chemical energy, for example, you know that methane, natural gas, is a high energy molecule. We can burn it in the laboratory in a Bunsen burner and see that energy is released in that process. So chemical energy is a type of potential energy. It's a form of stored energy, and if you're going, I'm still not clear about that, we'll come back to that and illustrate that in a minute when we look at food. Right here I'm showing an arrow connecting potential energy and kinetic energy. What that means is that it's possible to take kinetic energy and convert it into potential energy, or potential energy and convert it into kinetic energy. And we have just, in this statement, illustrated the first law of thermodynamics, which states that energy is neither created nor destroyed in any process. It can only be transferred from one form, example, kinetic energy, into another form, potential energy. So you can interchange, convert from one form of energy into another, but you do not create energy, you do not destroy energy. Let's take a look at how we can quantitate energy, how we can measure it. So there are units of energy. Metric units are the joule, spelled J-O-U-L-E, after the scientist whose work led us to a better understanding of these concepts, abbreviated capital J, or the English unit calorie, abbreviated lowercase c-a-l. And you can interconvert between joules and calories, and notice the conversion factor. 4.184 joules equals one calorie, and that is exact.